Hey everyone, welcome back to Beyond the Green Golf. Today's subject is going to be driver loft. Now that we have touched on the major parts of the golf club, from its loft to its lie, length, shaft flex, grip size, now as we start to go into more of the parts of the golf club a little bit more, now it'll make a little bit more sense. And then you can equate that to you, how you can use this information for you personally. Okay, so talking about driver loft today. Okay, driver loft, very important. The driver is a setup golf club. Very important to be able to utilize it to your best advantage. There's lots of talk about how the best players in the world are the ones that hit it the longest. That's not always true. But there is a decided advantage to being able to have a controlled shot that goes further to the green. You'll have a shorter iron into most greens and therefore should be able to shoot lower scores. But that's not always the truth. I mean, we've all met those folks that can really hit the ball far, but if they don't know where it's going, then it's kind of hard to be able to validate why they do that. I'm sure if you ask them most of the time, some would give up a little bit of that distance for a little bit more accuracy and lower scores. However, getting back on the subject, okay, so driver loft. Driver loft is very important. Let's talk about it literally. So too low of a driver loft will not create enough lift so that the ball will get the maximum amount of carry that we're looking for. Too high aloft, it'll waste energy going up and not out. So there's always a balance between those two things, okay? It's what you call more from a ballistic standpoint. So ballistics mean, you know, something that's going out on an angle and sort of flying. Again, that's a loose definition for all of you scientific folks out there. But it is important to make sure with the balance of too low, you're not getting the best of the ballistics out of it. Too high, same story. There's always a balance between. But there are some advantages. For instance, the lower the loft is, you can wind up with a little bit more ball speed. So if you're interested in more distance, sometimes you can do that, but I would recommend that more for somebody who has a fairly solid golf swing. And what I mean by that is where if you step up on a tee box, for the most part, you know whether or not it's going to the right or it's going to go to the left. Then at that point, you can kind of find some balance within there to make the best out of everything. But also don't forget, no matter what you are, who you are, no matter what you want, there is an end point to as far as you're going to be able to hit it, okay? I'm sorry to be the bearer of bad news on that one, but if it was easier to be able to do it any other way, then there'd be lots of guys that play drivers that are a lot longer, okay? So anyway, again, that's, you know, and a higher lofted on a driver can potentially give you a little bit less ball speed, but potentially a little more control. Why, you know, the reasoning why it's easier to hit an 8-iron than it is to hit a 6-iron. A little bit more loft, a little shorter, makes a big difference. Okay, so that's an important thing to understand. You know, when it boils down to it, if you have to try it physically on something on a measurable medium like a launch monitor of some variety, or you know, like a TrackMan or the Foresight launch monitors are very popular nowadays. Anything where you have a baseline to be able to look at it and find out what your long angle is, what your spin rate is, and what your ball speed is coming off of it as well. Again, all those things together. There is not one category that is more important than another, but it is, again, it's a balanced type of a thing. Okay, so to tighten it up, we really want to make sure that you're matched together with the proper loft and don't get caught up with an advertising campaign that says, you know, a higher loft or lower loft is going to make a difference. Go out and physically find out. If you have an interest in a particular model, try it in multiple lofts. Don't just go off of what one person recognizes, because in the end, recognizes as the correct loft for you. Try them and physically see whether or not it's going to make a difference for you. Again, in the end, you know, all we're really looking for as golfers is the best piece of equipment for what it is that we want to do with it. And that's it in a nutshell. So take the time, go to your local shops where somebody has a launch monitor that you can monitor, that you can look at physically what happens with all of the readouts from ball speed to spin rate and such, and look at that. Now, Swing speed does have a lot to do with the proper launch angle for a driver, and it's sort of a sliding scale. So again, when you go to a qualified fitter, you know, we'll talk more about launch angles. We'll talk a lot about, you know, again, in the refinement over the next few weeks. But I figured today would be just a great idea to talk about just driver loft alone, a short video, and then we'll, you know, again, we'll continue to go more in depth as we go on. Hey, thanks so much again for listening. Again, I know that this is gonna really invoke a lot of questions, so feel free to shoot back any feedback or any more questions about anything. And we look forward to seeing you very shortly. Take care.